back late January, early February, YouTube took away the automatic posting to Twitter and Google Plus. So you can no longer automatically send a tweet out when your video goes live. You're totally reliant on YouTube's notification system. Well, today we're going to show you an alternative that's going to make your life so much easier. Stay tuned.
Dark Hewson YT. Tech for content creation.
G'day, it's Doug from Doug Hewson YouTube, and we're here to help you with tech for content creation. And today we're looking at what's been taken away from YouTubers, and that's when you upload, to be able to set a custom YouTube message where it will share a link to your newly uploaded video to Twitter, Google Plus, and different places like that. Don't fear, there's a simple way, and we're going to use a service called If This Then That to automatically post the link and description of your videos to social media. Let's get on over to the computer right now and check it out. And we're looking today at what to do about auto posting now being turned off on YouTube. In other words, when you upload, let's do this. We go to upload. Okay, so I've selected a video. Now, as you can see over on this side, we no longer have a part where we can schedule a tweet with a tweet message. It used to be Twitter and Google Plus. They've taken that out. That's just been depreciated as of just in the past week from when I'm recording this. So now when I'm uploading a video, I have no way of promoting this other than trusting in YouTube's own notification system. What if I want to let people know who are following me on Twitter or Instagram or LinkedIn or whatever social media platform, Facebook, of course, any of those social media platforms? Well, I'm going to show you one way you can do that using a program or a service, I should say, called IFTTT, or If This Then That. Okay, so simply what you need to do is go to ifttt.com. And you'll come to this particular website here. When you first come to it, it's going to look like this. So then you can sign up for an account, and it doesn't cost you anything. Just sign up. You can sign up with your email address or link it to your Google account, whatever you want to do. Let me just sign in. You can see I've got some things in place for YouTube services, and the two that I've set up are these two here. Because basically it's like old school programming. If this happens, then do this task. So it's like an old school basic programming, computational language. You create your own applets by picking an action and picking what you want to happen. In this case, we've picked the action. If a new public video is uploaded on YouTube to my particular account, then this is sending a set action on LinkedIn via my buffer account. So I'm getting a post on LinkedIn. This one here is doing a post directly to my Twitter account. And you can follow me on Twitter at DougHewsonYT. So let's go into one of these. Let's go to the Twitter one because I think that's easier to follow. It tells me that it's using the YouTube service and Twitter service. But let's go through setting one of these up. First of all, we want to do a new applet. So we go and click over here. And then we get this, if this, and then that. So we don't want to tell what the this is first. What's the action that is going to trigger? So what's the trigger? Okay, first of all, I want to choose a service. Okay, so in this case, we want YouTube. So I'm going to start typing YouTube. And then I get YouTube here. So I'm going to click on YouTube. And these are the things that you can do at the moment as a trigger from YouTube. We can trigger something every time we like a video. If we upload a public video. A new public video from subscriptions. This triggers fires every time a specific user you subscribe to makes a video public. So this is where you can follow somebody that you've subscribed to and get and maybe create some sort of action based on their upload. We can also set an action if we receive a super chat while we're live streaming, and if we receive a channel membership, if we have such things activated on our accounts. Okay, but the one we're concerned with is if we upload a video and it goes public, we want people to be alerted through our social media. So we're going to pick a social media. We've selected that now. So we've got the YouTube, we've got the if, and now we're going to program the that. What is the result? What do we want to have happen? Here we go. Okay, this time we're going to go with Facebook. So I'm going to want to publish to my Facebook page. So I'm going to pick Facebook page. At the moment, for the Facebook pages, specifically for pages, I can create a status message, a plain text status message to appear on my Facebook page. I can create a link post, so it's a post with a link in it, which could possibly link to our YouTube video. Upload a photo from a URL, which is not what we're looking at today. So I think the best one for us is, because we want it to link to our YouTube video. So we're going to create a link post. Now, it's a similar process. If it was Twitter or something else, you go to pick the Twitter one and then pick the actual, what we call action that you can take. Okay, it says add a link URL. So it's asking us for the link URL and then the message. Now, the add ingredient means we can actually get it to fill in the title, description, and some other information here. But in this case, we're going to say video. And then we maybe want to tell it to put in the title. And we've already got the link URL up here. We don't want any of these other, we don't want the dates. We could possibly put in the description. The description, I think, possibly puts in the complete description of the video. We don't want to post that whole thing with affiliate links and other things. We just want the title and the URL so people can click on it. And then we can go create action. And there it says review and finish. And there's basically giving us a summary of what's happened. It's giving us a description that is written, but we can change that. It says, if the new public video is uploaded, then create a link post on Doug Hewson YT Facebook group, which is interesting. It didn't ask me which page. I've got multiple pages for different YouTube channels and stuff, but it has linked to the right one. So maybe because I've used that before for something, that it's automatically picked that. And then once we're done, we click the big finish at the bottom there, and we will end up with a applet that's in place. Now, I can optionally leave this on to receive notification when the applet runs. So when it runs, and it just like a little confirmation, say, hey, we've done this task. So if you upload a video, say you had all these applets going, then you're going to get like a notification from if this then that will tell you, hey, we've just done this task, sent that to your Facebook page. We've done this task, sent it to your Twitter. We've done this task, sent it to your LinkedIn. We've done this task, we've uploaded it to your blog, whatever it might be. But this is one way of doing it. We can click finish. We get here, it says, there's the finish thing here. It says it's turned on. You can actually toggle these on and off. Now let's go back to my applets and we can see all the ones we got now. You can see all the ones that are active. Say, they have a little green dot and say on. You can see all my YouTube ones have. Now I'm not currently using that for Facebook per se myself. That's why I use that as an example, because I'm not particularly using Facebook at the moment. So what I'm going to do is turn the Facebook one off, because I don't want that to actually fire. So what I do is I click on that, and you can see now it goes gray, says it's turned off. If we go back to the main page, it's an option for the future. I can turn that back on. At the moment, I'm running the Twitter one. If I go into that, you can see if a new public video is uploaded, then post a tweet. Now I've been rambling a bit on this video, so let's wrap this up by looking at a video I posted. Actually, I did my live stream last night, so when that went live, that should have triggered my buffer on my LinkedIn and everything. So let's jump on over. There it is there. 24 hours ago, that sounds about right. It's the new video. I mean, it wasn't my live stream, so. And there it is. Put the title of the live stream and the link. And that's all it's done. Unfortunately, you can't customize the message using this method like you could do with the settings when you used to be able to just set up the auto tweet to go off when your video goes live. You could basically put in a custom message. This doesn't have the custom message. If you want to do that, you have to continue to do that manually by going to your video, go share. When it comes up to share, you can edit the actual words on the tweet to whatever you want to go out. So there you go. So there we know that the Twitter works. So let's go check the LinkedIn. I want to see my posts. Here we go. And I believe there it is. Oh, it's posted the whole thumbnail too. And people can actually watch the video on LinkedIn. So that's interesting. So yeah, you can see the LinkedIn one works fine and dandy as well. I have it not sent directly to LinkedIn, but I have it going through my Buffer account. So yeah, that's how you can use if this and that to continue to let people know that you've posted a video to your socials, like Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, all those wonderful places.
As you can see, If This Then That is a pretty powerful site that you can use to automate all sorts of processes. But particularly today, those YouTube uploads don't promote themselves. So make sure you get on there and work out some integrations that are going to work for your workflow. And if you've used If This and That before for something other than this upload process, but something that's really nifty and it could be a time saver for people, make sure you put it in the comments below, because I'd be really interested in hearing that. And don't forget to share this video for any YouTubers that you might think this information will be really useful for. They may not have thought of, hey, jump on If This and That and create some automations. And if you really like this and you want to stick around for more content from this channel, make sure to smash that subscribe button, in a good way, of course, and ring the bell for notifications for when there's more videos and when I go live. Well, this is Doug from Doug Hewson YouTube, and I'll catch you later.
Subscribe to Doug Hewson YT for more tech for content creation.